Namaste. Today I'm going to talk about the teachings of Zakir Naik, the famous Muslim preacher who has a TV station and a huge following. Now there are two things I want to clarify at the outset. First of all, we respect Quran, we respect Prophet Muhammad, we respect the great saints who have walked in the Islam, like Rumi, Athar, all great saints we do respect. Second thing is, yes, we do respect the eruditeness of Zakir Naik. Now, what we are opposing is the bigotry of Zakir Naik and the tall claims of Zakir Naik. Let me make it at the outset. I do not have millions of followers like Zakir Naik. Correct. Why? Because you take to Olympics. How many people qualify for the Olympic training? There are very few people will qualify for the Olympic training. You need to have an established record. You must have done already a lot of success. Then only they will qualify for the Olympic training. In fact, somebody went to a long jumper, was an Olympic trainer. She told me there is only 24 people who are training with him for 4 years. So if you want to experience God at the highest levels, you cannot have millions of followers. You cannot train millions of followers. You can only speak to them. So first of all, this is the problem with Zakir Naik. The problem with him is he has 130 million followers. Now we are asking, do you have a record? Do you have the number of hits? No, forget it. I don't have any followers because I am a lover of God and everybody is a lover of God. I will quote Albert Camus. Don't walk in front of me. I cannot follow you. Don't walk behind me. I cannot wait for you. Walk besides me as my friend. So I am a lover of God. I love everybody. I don't want anybody to follow me. I do not want to be followed by anybody because it's very simple. Everybody follows God. Everybody follows the will of God. That is all. The highest levels of the test match, how many people will train for a cricket test match? Very few people. So to get qualified at that level, you cannot have a mass following. And second thing, a lover of God will not ill-treat anybody saying, you are my follower. He will say, follow God, follow the dictums of the teachings of the Great One. That is all. So it is all your pumped up ego that so many people are following me. Now, there is a quotation from Taittiriya Upanishad, there is a quotation, okay. There is two problems with the entire thing. God in the absolute sense is formless, nameless, which every religion accepts. Hinduism, Muslim, Judaism, every religion accepts. In fact, some African tribes also accept in description of that. But God in practice, how do you reach God? Everybody uses a prop. Now, for example, you ask somebody to do yoga. Now, they cannot do Shirasasana. They need a prop. They need a guide. They need to do some preliminary step. Then only they can reach at the higher levels. So, expecting everybody to understand the absolute truth is not possible. So, people have developed systems. People have developed objective systems. For example, you can use sexuality to reach God. It is called Pariyanga Yogam. It has been practiced in Taoism. It has been practiced in Tantra time immemorial. Now, the second thing is you can use breath. The great Matsyendranath talks about Swara Yoga about it. Now, you can use music. You can use dance. You can use poetry. Poetry is Jalaluddin Rumi. In fact, that great Jalaluddin Rumi's whirling, where they create a vortex and a pillar of light, which is being taken as a UN, as a thing to be preserved. There is no God in that. But yet they reach the highest state of consciousness. So Zakir.
Semisens from the Mevlevi Order of Whirling Dervishes are the only ones allowed to perform the ceremony. It's captivating for us, but meant for the heavens. A powerful display performed in a trance-like state.
While we whirl, we say Allah. It's the name of the God. We don't think anything about our family, our work, other people, just Allah.
Every spin, every body position is a deliberate, intentional gesture meant to honor God and embrace His benevolence.
Right hand looks to the sky.
Mm-hmm. So Zakir Nayak, please understand there are as many millions of people, there are millions ways to train towards moving towards the absolute consciousness. It is not your words alone or one book alone which has the noble truth. No. In fact, Gautam the Buddha says that there are 8 steps you need to follow. Mahavira talks about Yama and Niyama. So therefore, to claim that it is all about ideal worship, all the religions are talking, is absolutely wrong. In fact, the great Vashishta says, Advaita na Samshaya. He says, do not speak the absolute truth to everybody. Everybody cannot understand. So there is painting. In fact, Jonathan Livingstone Seagull talks about the bird who is reaching God. That entire book is that. And there is a samurai. It's called Last Samurai. And that he talks about how the sword fighting makes him to go into Satori. In fact, the Zen has developed the tea ceremony, Ikebana, martial arts, where Miyamoto Musashi talks about the absolute. In fact, the founder of the Aikido, he talks about his enlightenment. So the point is, people have reached absolute consciousness even without the concept of God, even in your religion like Jalaluddin Rumi. Jalaluddin Rumi says very beautifully, he says, that which you are searching is also searching for you. He says, you are also not searching for God. God is also searching for you. So the point is saying that ideal worship is wrong. Ideal worship is a methodology. It is required for few people. Maybe you don't require that. That is all. Now, the second one is, the theory of Islam is very different from practice of Islam. Now, Islam has so many sects, so many varieties. In fact, they go about beating where the blood comes about. There's a bloodletting ritual which is there. You have Sunni, Shia, Wahhab. You have a variety of... Why, if it is absolute truth, why there are so many schools, why there are so many sects? It is because variety is the way of life. Everything in the world will come to variety. You are trying to make everything into one, nothing else. So stop fibbing about your knowledge. Because you quote few Hindu scriptures, it does not mean that you have understood about God. There was a friend of mine who used to go on talking in younger days about sex. He was such a sex pervert. He used to write, he used to paint, he used to talk, go on talking. In fact, we used to feel very, very bad he coming inside. Now he got married. After his marriage, after his first night was over, we called him up and he came to a meeting. He was having coffee. I asked him, what happened to, why you're not talking about anything about sex? He said, it is all very different. The way I talk is very different from the way I experience about it. Same thing, Zakir Nayak. If you had experienced God, you won't be blabbering so much. Going on blabbering. Why do you need to talk? You see a woman, when they fall in love, they don't talk. They don't write poetry. Have you ever seen a woman writing poetry? Very rare. So that's why I asked a woman, what do you do when you fall in love? He says, I merge with my beloved. And I try to give him a baby. That's being very practical. No woman will write poetry, will feel and cry and all that. A woman in love is very, very clear. Shall we have a commitment? hell or high water, I will stand with you. So stop talking about that God's love and all that thing you have not experienced. If you have experienced, you will be silent, or poetry will flow like Rumi, Atar, all those great saints, the Sufi saint, including the great Hakim Sanai. Let me quote, he knows the touch of the hand moving in darkness, know well to well about it. We tried our ways with reasoning, it never worked. Hakim Sanai, I am quoting you back. So this is the first problem. You cannot have follower if you are a lover of God. You cannot talk about hatred and say only monotheism, only one way must be there. There will be multiple ways. Also, the famous debate of Adi Shankara and Mandana Mishra is boiled down to what you are talking, Zakir Nayak. Adi Shankara says God is absolute, you don't need ritual. Mandana Mishra talks about Mimamsa. He said you need ritual, you need a prop. Adi Shankara wins the debate for a variety of reasons. It's okay. So the question is whether God is absolute form or about the formlessness has been going on. It is called Dvaita, Advaita, Vishishta Advaita. God the Son, God the Father, God the Holy Spirit. The Holy Trinity has been talked about time immemorial. So talking that, oh, why do you worship ideal worship? It is required for a few people. That is all. What is wrong in that? Since you have never practiced, you have always hated, you have always tried to use your tongue to give the bali of other people's religion, other people's belief. You go on talking. I met a saint. I met a real Himalayan saint. And I went and sat in his presence. He told me, this is the problem, you have come, it will get okay. I asked him, Swamiji, why? How is that you are answering all my questions even without me talking to you? He said, your mind is merged with God's mind. My mind is also merged with the God's mind. So there is no need to talk. But I am talking to you to make that understanding. That is all. So if you are a great saint, you don't need a question and answer. Why do you need a question and answer? You will simply say you recite Quran, you recite the great works of the Prophet, you do the Dua. Why do you need to answer questions and question and answer? You don't need. Which means in essence, I want to ask you, you are talking about follower of God. Are they following you? Are they following Quran? Are they following Muhammad? It's all true. They are following Quran. They are also getting inspired with your word and they are also following the Prophet Muhammad. So if these three things can coexist, God can exist with Advaita, Dvaita and Vishishta Advaita. That is all. Just because everybody keeps quiet, it doesn't mean that you can stand tall among the dwarfs and talk about it. Everything is multidimensional. When it is multidimensional, that is why the great Prahlad said very beautifully, Hiranyakashipu comes and asking, do you mean to say your God exists in this? He said, yes, God exists even in a tiny particle. God exists in everything. So you go on tapping this, you will find God. If you go on tapping the mic, at the end of it, everything is God. Aham idam sarvam brahmam. So what is the question of telling that if you do this, you will not reach God? You will know. Who said? Everybody will reach God. That is why when Saint told me, he said, boss, everybody will reach God sooner or later. It is just a long train. It is an illusion to think that you will not go back to your home. Some people have done faster, but maybe those lifetime they must have practiced. So please, Zakir Nayak, don't talk as if that you know everything and because you quote, it means you are well-read and you are Islam is the thing. You say, MashaAllah, we say Hare Krishna. Why do you say MashaAllah? Don't say if you are absolutely knowing. The problem is everybody needs to remember the word of God. In a Muslim, you have Ashtod, you have the 108 names of God. Why did they keep 108 names of God? If God was absolute, God is described in the qualities. So, the problem with the entire thing is, you are confused between the form and the formlessness of God. the method and the theory of God. That is where the problem and the confusion lies, Zakir Naik. That is why your son has become involved in terrorism. You are not a peaceful man. You are a violent man waiting to finish everybody. And please understand, there is a left hand of God. There is a right hand of God. No, in the absolute sense, no. But in the practice, the left hand of God does not have any rules. That is why you can drink, you can smoke, you can have as many women as possible. Now you see Islam, they wear black clothes. You see Aghoris, they wear black clothes. They write, everybody writes from left to right. Islam people write from right to left. We have sikar, you have beard. So it is all about reverse process. So it is tantra. Why does Muhammad says you can have as many women as possible? Because he must have practiced tantra. He must have used the sexual energy to sublimate his kundalini. So how can you say that it means you simply want to justify everything and says my religion is the best. That is all. It is like a simple child telling, I am the best, I am the best, I am the best, my thing are best. You are so uncertain. That is why you go on telling, I am the best, I am the best. So answer my two questions. What is wrong? In the right hand of God, you have a lot of discipline, Nema, which is brahmacharya, non-violence. You cannot eat. You'll have to fast. So the point is, there are methods which are available. If you want to reach using the mind of God. Now God has a mind. Please understand. God has everything. He is long, short and all. You can say, oh God, how can you have mind? You are an idiot if you say God doesn't have a mind. God has a heart. God has power. God is everything. So when a soul is taking the mind of God, it will go like Jesuits. It will go like the Sufis. When it is taking the heart of God, you will become a lover of God. Write poetry, do music. If you are going to go into the power of God, it is where the Agora and all the different sects which talks about it. So the point is, you are getting confused about the practice and the theory of God. And you need to understand, few people need a prop. That is why they have kept Devata Yoga. Now, when a lower astral is attacking you, and in the astral realm, you will not claim, because astral realm you have never studied, you have never experienced. So the point is, when the astral world opens up in the dream and in your death, and when the vortex of energy opens up, people need prop. So the point is, that is why people follow great men. Because in essence they are God. Anything you go deep, you will experience God. There was a Tibetan master who came. And he entered a monastery. There's a guy who said, I want to experience God. He said, come, we will do the sky meditation. He just, both of them lie down and he said, you experience the sky? He said, yes. You experience absolute emptiness? He said, yes. And that guy was gone. And he come back and touched the thing. Please don't talk about God. Make people experience about God. Why do you need to talk? Child talks. It is like talking about hunger and the dishes. When you eat, you do not talk. Somebody went to Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. He touched and they experienced cosmic consciousness. That's all. So the point is, all these fibbing. Oh, I am this. Oh, I am that. Oh, I am that. At the time of the death, when the tongue doesn't open, the mind is into delusion and pain. When the effect of crucio happens, can you remember your prayer? It is very, very difficult. So they have a dream bardo practice. So different religions have developed different methodology. So please understand that absoluteness of God. When even Bhagwan Ramanak talked about it, he talked about a method. He never talked about God. He said, ask who I am. It is like a Zen koan. Zen koan, there is no God. They say, what is the sound of one hand clapping? That is all.
What is the sound of one hand clapping?
I don't know. What is the sound of one... Oh, 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 oh.
So, the point, Zakir Nayak, you might be a very elderly person, but you might be a child in the world of spirituality. There is classification in psychology. There is classification in everything. Not all souls are equal. There is classification in business. Top 100 fortune companies. There is classification in the countries. There is classification in the rule. So, everybody cannot understand the absolute truth in one go. Buddha says it has to be repeated. Once for the eyes, once for the ears, once for the nose, one for the tongue. The problem is you are massively egoistic about the learning. It is called Vidya Garvam. If your memory is gone, entire sadhana is gone. And in the left hand of God, according to their practice, they can give bali. That bali is called Bakrit. That bloodletting is called as the, what you call it as, cup therapy, they put it. So, please understand each one according to their swabhava and nature and about the approach has a very different methodology. So, don't talk about absoluteness of God and corner people saying that, oh, you are worshipping demigod. There are people and methodology which you have not never read. Have you read Swara Yoga of Matsyendranath? No. Have you read the sutras of Patanjali? Have you read the Shiva Samhita? He says, knowing, using the mantra is one method. The first method talks about breath in Shiva Samhita. So please, please, don't talk rubbish. Don't talk, don't claim yourself to be absolute. Nobody questioned me. Nobody did that. It is like a little boy going and telling him, Amma, nobody questioned me in my eye. Who wants to be questioned? Second thing, I don't expect you to call me. The very, very simple. Answer it through your TV itself. We will have a debate at that level. We don't need debate of meeting people. Why? Because sitting and watching, the grass grows by itself when the spring comes. That is all. In an absolute stillness, when you experience the divine light, divine consciousness, you will be writing poetry. Streams of tears will come as love. Not this hatred what you are talking, Zakir Nayak. So please do not confuse between Advaita, Dvaita and Vishishta Dvaita. Advaita, the great Shankaracharya said, Shivoham Shivom, everything is consciousness. Ramanuja said, there is both form and formlessness. Then the great Madhva Guru, Madhvachari said very beautifully. He said, God and you are different. You need method and practice. Stop fibbing. So do not confuse between the practice and the method and the diversity. And there are objective method without using any God's name. People have transcended the consciousness. God can be used as a bhava of a father, bhava of a mother, bhava of a wife, bhava of a lover. Some people can relate. They worship on the emotions part of the life. Just like vata, pitta, kapha exist, just like type A, type B, type C, there are personality exist and there are props are needed for the people. So don't claim that that everybody who is using a prop is a kafir. So please, this is not an intellectual argument. Please change yourself. Maybe our guys knows how to, they have never read the scriptures like you. That's why I said I appreciate your eruditeness. You have read many books, nothing wrong. You'll go on reading, you'll never practice. So therefore, if a person has experienced hunger, if a person has experienced love, if a person has experienced sex or God, they will never talk about it like this. They will never have a hate campaign. You are developing monsters with your speech. You are telling, go kill people. You have a double tongue. Private you will talk, public you will talk one thing. Because you are frightened, I don't have fear. What I am inside is what I am outside. I do not have followers. Because I train people for the World Olympics. That is what huge spirituality difference. LKG, everybody is telling how many people reach PhD. So therefore, people need props. There are methods you have no understanding. Zakir Naik, including the great whirling of Jalaluddin Rumi, where there is no God. So please, please stop fibbing. Stop trying to say things, oh, you have this, you have that. You are also remembering the name of God. That is why we have called Mahavakyas, Aham Brahmasmi, Shivoham Vishnuham. That is the same thing what you are using as MashaAllah. First there was word and the word was with God and the word became God. It's called Nama Smarana. It's also a technique used by you. So what is wrong if somebody identifies consciousness with that name? Instead of a limited personality, Jesus is identified as a person, God the Son, then God the Father, God the Holy Spirit. When they move into the extreme consciousness, he is taken as an absolute sense. So please understand, don't talk like this, all this childish fashion and the people who have 100. And another problem is Hindus have dollar a dozen philosophers. In your thing, there are very limited people. And you people don't believe in talking. You believe in, all your great kings believe in action. So if you have the guts, if you have the courage, don't look at my followers. Answer my question. Have you tried Swara Yoga? Have you tried Paryanga Yoga? So Devata Yoga in itself is very, very different. It is not about demigod worship. It is a worshipping. Oh, why do you worship fire? You are using a name which is an air element. If you have reached absolute sense, you also don't need a method. So don't question about other people. They can worship, use fire and reach God. Air and reach God. Earth and reach God. Somebody use magic and reach God. So the point is, it is all about reaching the ultimate consciousness. And please don't follow me, Zakir Nayak. I don't have followers. I have only lovers. And lovers don't follow. And those who follow are not lovers. Is this not poetical? Please answer this. Then we can talk about other things. So you say, oh, I won the debate. What is there to talk to debate? Ramakrishna went for a debate. Somebody called him up. He said, okay. The fellow spoke, he simply went and hugged. He said, oh wow, what a way you speak. There's nothing to talk. Enough of this theory. You have Japamala, we also have Japamala. What is wrong? Everybody has killed in the name of religion. Hindu, Muslim, Christian, everybody, Buddhist, everybody has killed. There are rogues and rascals in every religion. I hope you do not become a rogue or a rascal. You do not become the two-tongued snake which you are there. And I pray God with all my consciousness. May Zakir Nayak be filled with your divine light and divine love. May he stop preaching this hatred and killing people. May he never be followed. May his words be tested in real time. So be it, so be it, so be it.